It's my pleasure to introduce this town's well-known eye doctor, Dr. Rayford Edgar, who's been married to his wife for 64 years. We're pleased to have you. Dr. Edgar graduated from the Water Valley School System from the University of Mississippi and the Southern College of Optometry. Dr. Edgar has always supported our local town through the Lions Club, Chamber of Commerce, the school board, housing authority, plus he's been on many, many committees. Dr. Edgar served in World War II in the U.S. Navy from 1942 to 46. He saw action in the South Pacific, and he participated in 12 island campaigns. He's a member of the American Legion here in Water Valley. He's also a life member of Post 4100, our VFW. Last October, Dr. Edgar was part of the storm on the Capitol in Washington, D.C. Some of us know about that. Some may not. That's where veterans were barred from the Capitol with barricades. And these veterans, Dr. Edgar included, removed them physically and entered.
I want to congratulate all of you here today attending this event. We do really do appreciate it. You know, this really is a day of remembrance for those that had lost their lives in their service to their country. It started out really as a program sponsored by the Union and Confederate people, and as they laid wreaths on their graves in Arlington Cemetery in 1868. Everything changed up just a little bit, and we now have a specified day, which was by Congress by 1971 on the last Monday in this month. So that's the reason why we are here today. We're just absolutely great that we can celebrate this particular event. Since we have this event today, without making a long speech about anything which I've already cut back, I would like to bring to your attention something that really is really dear to my heart, and it will be to yours when I get through. In 1942, in our high school here, our class, we had 30 boys and 10 girls. We had people coming in at the same time. We were all about 17 years of age, asking us if we would like to go ahead and sign up. Then we might have the opportunity to go into the type of service that we wanted to when we reached a little bit later. They also promised if we'd sign up, we would go ahead and get a diploma at the specified time. We had a guy in there with us that said, that's fine, but I'm going ahead and enlist in the Marines. And he did. This was a cousin of Curtis Berry. His name was James A. Kelso. James A. Kelso volunteered for the Marines he got ready and left. We had a get-together for him here in Water Valley, and he appreciated that, but he said, I want to tell you one thing. He said, I won't be back. She said, oh, Kelso, you'll be back. You don't worry about that, man. You'll do good. He said, I'm telling you right now, I won't be back. And he wasn't back. Kelso was killed in the Battle of Guam. Kelso did not come back. But what he did for our country, what can you do for our country? Thank you.